In order to become a pro Call of Duty player, countless hours must be sacrificed and it has to be done consistently. No matter how much you love the game, if you play for 12 hours a day back to back for months on end, you're going to inevitably burn out. And you're going to be forced to have to take those off days. Most players never finish out a full title and they just come back at the beginning of next year and expect to pick up where they left off. If you're good, you can pick it up just like riding a bike, but don't expect to be out cycling Tour de France champions after a 6-month hiatus. Here's a clip from the Joe Rogan Experience to better explain what I mean.
So if the challenge is too high, you'll meet anxiety. If it's too low, you're boredom. When I go in the practice room, I'm trying to create flow. I'm having fun. Training should be addictive. Imagine training was addictive. Everybody would train, everybody would be fit. But people always go into anxiety. They go and they kill, they slam their body. Then I have to convince you to do it again 3 days later, 2 days later. And you're like, dude, the mental energy is going to take me to get there. Like, it shouldn't be. It should be, training should be a pulling force. It should be pulling you. You want to go training. If you don't want to go training, it's not fun. If it's not fun, you're not going to do a lot of it. Mm. And if you're not going to do a lot of it, you're never going to reach mastery. So how do I make it pleasurable? How to make it fun? I have to be in a flow state. And you can get into a flow state in almost anything. But when you're out of that flow state, cut it. We're going to get further. We're going to do more training if we cut it today and come back in tomorrow. Because I'm a big believer in consistency over intensity.
Please keep in mind that I'm obviously not a pro player, but this is just the knowledge that I've collected since Call of Duty Ghosts. Obviously, we have to play for several hours a day, several days a week. Where else the next guy online is going to get past us, and nobody likes to be surpassed by someone worse than them. This is an everyday hustle, so you can't afford to be taking off days, and especially not off weeks. You have to get in those eights, you have to get those pro points, you have to play that tournament, whatever, but at what cost? The things that tend to suffer the most are usually your physical health and your social life, but as most of you can agree, your mental health gets absolutely obliterated by this grind. There's always something going on that you can use as a tool to get past other people at your level. So the condition FOMO, also known as fear of missing out, runs real deep in this community. So if you don't know what that is, look into it. It's very important. In order to play consistently and to not keep giving up every year, you should try to focus on those things that tend to suffer when you do compete, so you don't have to go back and overcompensate for the time that you lost playing 6 months of Call of Duty. Going into Cold War, this is arguably the most promising year that competitive COD has had in a long time. So I really don't want any of you to regret quitting this year, because this could really be some of yours year. Yeah, some of your years. Fuck. There's so many videos about burnout, and I'm gonna link a couple of my favorite down in the description below. But here are three things that I think Call of Duty players specifically should focus on going into Cold War to prevent you from burning out. Number one is your routine. You should work smarter, not harder. Use your time efficiently and perfect a schedule that works best for you and is pretty productive. Number two is gonna be your habits. Get more in tune with yourself this year. Going pro in anything requires self-awareness like a motherfucker. So figuring out what your strengths and shortcomings are really helps. A couple things I suggest are gonna be journaling, meditation, and content creation. Those three things specifically help you a lot focus on yourself, help you focus a lot on yourself and keep you a little bit more aware of your faults and successes, obviously, like I said. So keeping yourself accountable is really the best way to become the person that you want to be. And number three is going to be your environment. Everybody knows you're a product of your environment. And if you have a messy room, chances are you have a messy mind. Work on perfecting your systems, keep things kept up this year, and enjoy looking at your setup so that every time you look away, you're not just in disgust by all of the Coke cans and Hershey wrappers. This will make you crave to sit at your desk and to play rather than despising it. So regardless of how many hours that you do play that week or day or whatever, it's kind of hard to look at that setup and not want to play it. Now, everything that I've said in this video is pretty subjective, so take that with a grain of salt for who you are, but experiment with all these different things, and if anything else works for you specifically, let me know down in the comment section below. Hopefully you guys all watching this have a great rest of the day, and I'm out. Peace.